Hello and welcome to UpToDate Skills YouTube channel. I'm Joanna, and today I'm going to show you step by step how you can create a YouTube API key for your online projects. If you are watching this video, you probably know what the YouTube API key is for, so let's just start with our tutorial. If you have a YouTube channel and want to share your videos on your website, sooner or later you will probably need to create an API key to interact with YouTube's data somehow and to use some functionalities that YouTube has to offer to help you grow your audience. The first thing you have to do to get your YouTube API key is make sure you are logged in to your Google account. Then open a web browser and go to the Google Developed Console. The link is console.developers.google.com. I will leave the link in the description below so that you can easily have access to it. Once this page opens, you will see this dashboard here. This is your Google API console, and this is where we will create our YouTube API key. There are three APIs available for YouTube at the time of this recording. You can see the YouTube APIs if you click here where it says Enable APIs and Services. Now we are in the API library. You can type YouTube in this search field here, or you can just scroll down, which is what I'm going to do. And here they are. Our three options are YouTube Data API V3, YouTube Analytics API, and YouTube Reporting API. The one we need is the YouTube Data API V3. I suggest you click on it to read all the details. Don't worry, we are not going to read everything now. I just want to show you what type of information you can get here, because if you are doing this by yourself, it might be useful to maximize the potential of the API key we are about to create. You will see something different here, but I will get to that in a minute. You have an overview section, some documentation, followed by the support section, where you will be able to see all you can do with this API. Take your time to do some reading, and when you're done, it's time to create our API key. Let's go back to the Google Developers Console dashboard, because that's where you will usually start if you need to create another API for some reason or edit an API that you have already created. You can just go back or use the link again if you don't find this page. On your Google Developers dashboard, click on this drop-down list. Well, if this is the first time you are creating a project, then it's just a button that takes you to an empty project list. It will become a drop-down list when you have multiple projects in your Google Developers console. Actually, this is where you will see all the projects you create, and you can access them from here. So let's click on it and then click again on New Project. Now you have to name your project. I'm going to name mine YouTube API for UpToDate Skills. UpToDate Skills is my project on YouTube and other platforms. Don't forget to check it out and subscribe to get updates on new videos and, of course, to help me keep my project going. Well, let's go back to work. Once you name your project, click Create. The next step is looking for the API again and the API library. We can get to it through this link here or through this one that we have used before. Alternatively, you can also use the search field at the top of the page and just type YouTube. Let's try the search field option this time. Just type YouTube in the search field and look for YouTube Data API V3 from the drop-down list. Here it is. Click on it. If this is the first time you are creating an API for YouTube, this will be a little different for you, so you won't see Manage. You will see Enable on this button here. And once you click on the Enable button, you will be taken back to the API dashboard. So click on Enable if this is the first time, and click on Manage if you have other APIs created. On this panel here on the left, click on Credentials. Then click on Create Credentials and select the option API Key. And here it is. This is your API. Before you copy your API key, you have to take care of this warning sign that says that this key is unrestricted, which basically means it's not secure. So you have to create some restrictions to make it safer. To do so, we can click here where it says API key, and you will be taken to the API settings page. If you need to come back to this page again, you can also get to it by looking for the project you created here at the drop-down list at the top of the page or here on credentials. This will be useful later if you need to come back to the API settings page or to copy the API key again. Let's scroll down a bit. As you can see here, the restrictions are set to none by default. So you have to set some restrictions yourself to keep it secure. If you read the documentation about APIs, you will see that they even suggest deleting old APIs and creating new ones from time to time. And you shouldn't share your API publicly. And for that reason, I will have to delete this one after this tutorial. Let's see our options now. The first restriction is websites. The second restriction option is IP addresses. And the last two options let you name which apps you can use your API key in. I'm going to show you how to use these two first options. Option one, websites, and option two, IP addresses. Let's start with option one, websites. When you click on it, you will see some very useful instructions here. This restriction type here, websites, lets you specify which websites can use the API key you have just created. If you choose this option, you can write your domain, or you can go through these options here on the right and check which options are best for you. Again, these instructions will only show once you select the option websites. To show you how this works, I'm going to add three restrictions. So let's scroll down a bit and click Add. The first restriction I'm going to add is this one here. To make things easier, I'm just going to select this and copy it and paste it into this field. Of course, we can't keep the word example nor the .com unless your website is a .com. So I'm going to write mine, UpToDateSkills.com, and hit done. Remember, you have to change the word example and you cannot use UpToDateSkills.com. You have to use your own website. This specific restriction we have just set limits the use of the API to your own website, but it doesn't include subdomains. If you do have subdomains and want the API to work there too, then you click on Add again to insert another restriction. If you just have one subdomain, then you use this option here. Then you can copy and paste this option here into this field, and then you replace this bit with your own subdomain and domain here. I'm going to hit done. I'm not going to use this one though. Let's say you have more than one subdomain. Then you should go for this option here. This star here says that you are going to set this API key for all the subdomains that are included in your website. Let me copy and paste it into here. And again, let me replace the example.com with UpToDateSkills.com and hit done. When you are replacing the website, make sure you leave the star and the dot. Otherwise, this won't work like it's supposed to. Now let's click Add again. And now we are going to add star.googleapis.com. Then you have a forward slash and another star. This is exactly the same for you and me. And then you hit done. This doesn't show here, but you can use this option here so that Google can provide metadata for the YouTube API. I will leave these three options in the description below. But remember, I will be using these examples, and you have to replace the word example and all the information here with your own website. The only restriction where you don't do any changes is this one, star.googleapis.com/star. I don't know if you've noticed, but the warning sign is still here. It says, if left blank, your API key will accept requests from any website. But it's not blank at all. We have already added these three options. The problem is there is one step missing. Scroll down. You have to click on this option here where it says restrict key. Then you have to click on this drop-down list and look for the YouTube Data API V3. Click on it and hit OK. Once you're done, you have to hit Save to complete the process. Now you can copy your API key. To copy your API key, you can click on Show Key. And then you can click on this icon here to copy the key. Code copied. Hit Close. You can go to your website now and use the key. However, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to show you how you can set up the other restriction, the second option. So let's go to the API key again. Scroll down, and the option I'm going to show you now is IP addresses. In this option, you can insert the IP address of your website, for example. Just like the previous option, if you click on it, you can see some details down here. The first time I tried to use this feature, I didn't really know what the IP address for my website was. I still don't know it by heart, so I had to learn that too. There are many ways to get it, but since we are working with a Google product, I'm going to show you a Google tool that you can use to get the IP address of your website or any other website. It's called Google Toolbox or Google Admin Toolbox. Well, you can just Google it, but I'll share the link in the description too. So let me just open a Google page and look for the Google Admin Toolbox. This is the page we want to get to, Dig DNS Lookup, but let me show you how you can get to it from the Google Toolbox main dashboard. So I'm going to click the first option, Google Admin Toolbox. Then we have to open this menu here at the top, look for the option Dig, and click on it. Now let's do some digging. Here, you have to type in the domain whose IP address you need to find. I'll write UpToDateSkills.com. And the IP address just shows down here. It is this number under the word data. Let's copy this number. And let's go back to our Google API console. Click Add and paste the IP address of your website. Not this one, of course. Well, then click Done. Don't forget to scroll down. This time, I'm doing this for the second time, so this is already selected. However, if you start by the IP address, you will have to select this again and hit OK. The last thing you have to do is hit Save to finish the process. Now your restrictions are set to IP addresses. Well, you know the drill. To get your API key, just click on Show Key and hit this icon here on the right to copy the key. And now you can paste it on whatever project you were working on. Hit Close. If you have a WordPress website and don't know how to integrate the YouTube API key into the website, you can watch another tutorial I have created for that. I will leave a link in the description for that tutorial too. Check out all the links in the description and don't forget to like this video and hit subscribe to help me keep my project going and to get updates on new videos. Well, I guess this is it. See you in the next tutorial.